In a previous video, we saw how spirulina and blue-green algae may be dangerous for our health due to the potential contamination with something called beta-methylamino-L-alanine, or BMAA, which is a destructive neurotoxin. In light of those findings, spirulina supplement companies seem to take action. In his April 2019 Q&A, Dr. Michael Greger was asked again about spirulina, and here's what he had to say.
So what are my thoughts on spirulina? Is it safe while pregnant? I'm afraid it may not even be safe when you're not pregnant, and that's because of neurotoxic compounds that have been found contaminating spirulina supplements on the shelf, and spirulina manufacturers say this spirulina does not create this toxin, which may very well be the case, but the way they cultivate spirulina is they basically grow it kind of outdoors, and there's contamination with other blue-green algae, for example, that do make these toxins. Regardless, it's found on the shelf, and so that's all we really care about, whether or not it came from a contaminant algae or from spirulina itself. And so if you're looking for a green powder to sprinkle on your popcorn or something, I'd encourage you to do chlorella instead, where there have not been any toxins found. It makes your popcorn a bright green, which kids will love. We call it zombie corn in my household.
There may also be another serious problem with consuming spirulina, blue-green algae, and even with seaweeds like dulse, and it's all to do with vitamin B12 absorption. So let's hear as Dr. Michael Clapper explains more.
This is the B12 molecule. Turns out that a lot of organisms in the plant world make or try to make vitamin B12 for their own needs. They come close. This is a fairly close approximation. But to you chemistry geeks out there, you'll notice that this pentose with the two nitrogens, that's now been broken open here. Phosphorus here that had a hydroxyl group now has a double bonded oxygen to it. And this pentose ring has now been broken open as well. So it's not the same molecule, and it doesn't do what B12 does. It will not keep your brain healthy, will not keep your spinal cord healthy. But what it will do is occupy the receptor sites on your nerve cells so real B12 can't get in. You don't want to be taking these B12 analogs. Well, it turns out that some sea vegetables make these B12 analogs. And for that reason, as I said, to get your iodine, if you use the sea vegetables, do them a couple times a week, but don't take it on the day that you're also taking your B12 supplement. Take your B12 supplement on a Sunday, start adding the sea vegetables to your salad on Wednesday or Thursday, but just space it out a little bit. Don't flood your body with these B12 analogs when you're trying to get real B12 into your tissues. Okay? Now, speaking of B12 analogs, surprise, surprise, there's a couple of health supplements generally recognized as good for you that aren't. Spirulina and blue-green algae. If anybody's taking them, I'd suggest you reconsider that strategy, because they are loaded with B12 analogs. They analyzed spirulina tablets, and 83% of the molecules that look like B12 were actually B12 analogs. And the same thing with blue-green algae. These B12 analogs, pseudo-B12, turns out to be the predominant substance, and it is definitely not suitable for vegans, and it will block your real B12 from getting in there. But if you're taking spirulina or blue-green algae and think you're doing something good for yourself, you're not. Reconsider that.
So what about chlorella? Well, chlorella is a green algae and not a blue-green algae. And a study conducted in Finland found that chlorella may potentially contain human bioactive vitamin B12. The study examined the vitamin B12 status in long-term adherents of a strict, uncooked vegan diet, who were compared with 21 omnivores. The researchers found that the vegans consuming chlorella algae had serum vitamin B12 concentrations twice as high as the vegans that were not using it. 6 of 9 vegans that were not consuming chlorella showed slow but consistent deterioration of vitamin B12 status over a 2-year observation period. On the basis of these results, the researchers concluded that chlorella consumed in large amounts can supply adequate amounts of bioavailable vitamin B12. Other researchers who have looked at chlorella have found human active B12 in it, which would support the finished study. However, I think it would be extremely unwise to rely on chlorella for our B12 intake, but it appears that it's not as harmful as spirulina when it comes to blocking B12 absorption. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up, leave a comment below, and subscribe for more upcoming videos.